Waiting for the clap, yeah. Alrighty, let's be great. I wanna love you and treat you right. I wanna love you every day and every night. Once again, it's on, people. I am Brian Redman. This is The Relationship Rehab. And today, we're gonna talk about family. And the question that I'm gonna propose is family synonymous? Yeah, that's a big word there, you see that? Synonymous with business. So I guess I'm asking, is family like a business? And I believe, in my humble opinion, the answer is yes. I believe that family is synonymous with business. You should treat your family and treat the concept of your family and the idea of your family and the mission of your family, the focus of your family should be treated and looked at as a business. And what I mean by that is not to say that I wish it was as easy for us to hire and fire our family members, although we can't. But be that as it may, I still think that there are a lot of principles that we use, I guess, in the business world that we could absolutely use in our families and kind of adopt some of those things to make us better, which is why I'm doing this. So I think that if you look at your family like a business, I guess that would mean that we start out from the top, I guess, as far as the hierarchy is concerned. You're basically talking about two people going into business, right? You're talking about a man and a woman, or two partners, whatever you want to call it, going into business and saying, hey, this is what we're going to do. We're going to join our lives together for the betterment of each other, and we are going to do this thing together, share our lives together, and just be wonderful and great, right? So with that being said, I think that with those two partners, number one, they should complement each other. I think that they also should have a shared vision. I do think that there are certain things that each one can do and have that is not necessarily, hey, we're both doing what this one person is doing or we're doing what this person is doing. I think that you can have a family to where when you start out, those two people, you can have it to where one person is the person that is the leader, the visionary, and then that other person plays just an equally important role as being that support system, being that person that is encouraging and all those type of things. So I think they're equally important. I don't really believe in people doing like the same thing, because I think if you're doing the same thing, then it's kind of redundant and it's like, why are we both doing this? And we both have our own goals and visions and dreams that we want to do, but if we're both doing the same exact thing, then I don't know, to me it kind of makes it seem like it's a little redundant as far as doing that. So but when you have it to where two people can play in different roles, you have it where people can do different things and have different positions, and it works together for the team, I think that definitely makes for a great business or business partner relationship or family, right? So I would say one of the things too, as far as, and I guess I would kind of want to focus on those two business partners and what they should be doing and how they should be thinking, because a lot of times in business, the line level people or the people that are, you know, out in it every single day and they're getting that instruction from the higher ups, I think that a lot of times that those people, that in between, that message that comes down, it doesn't necessarily translate as well. And you can have disgruntled employees and you can have leadership that's in place that really aren't doing the best that they could be doing. And I think that that's really important. So it's like as family members, I think the same thing. So we need to look at those other people that are in your family as employees in your business or business partners, whatever the case may be. But look at it in the sense that everybody has a position to play and that position is important. I think a lot of times in life, we think that people are in our family and regardless of whether their age is, whether they're old, whether they're young, what their qualifications are as far as education, do they have their diploma, do they have their degree, do they go to this school or that school? I think that a lot of times we let those things kind of cloud who that person really is and what they have to offer. And I think that everybody as an individual has something to bring to the table that is unique and very important, just for that fact alone. Your thoughts and your ideas are just as important as the person who's in charge, because at the end of the day, you are an individual, you are unique, and therefore what you have to offer can't be reproduced or duplicated. So everybody has something to offer and they should be treated as such. Definitely keep that in mind. Also, too, another point is that business owners must be able, and this is very important, must be able to hold each other accountable and responsible for what they do and what they say. And let's translate that over to the relationship side of things. You being in that relationship with that other person, you need to be able to hold that person accountable for their actions, for the things that they do, things that they say, and hold them responsible for it too. I think a lot of times in relationships, we don't do that. And because we don't, we have a lot of breakdown in communication. We have business partners that may be unhappy with each other. And as time goes, that being unhappy over this one or two or three or four situations, I think it snowballs into a just automatic breakdown into, I'm sorry, not automatic, but ultimate breakdown in that business relationship, and it kind of destroys the company. Because at the end of the day, when you have this business and you're in this, you have this family concept, and it's you and that other person, if you guys decide to part ways, that's one thing, and hey, you take what you have, I take what I have, whatever the case may be, and that's it, business is over, and we can go on with our lives. However, when you have employees, you have children, and you have other family members that are involved in this relationship, then now you're talking about not just dismantling two business partners, you're talking about dismantling a company. And with that, there's a lot of fallout. So being able to hold each other accountable is important and should be definitely established early on in the relationship. Because once you're able to do that, then you are able to make each other better. When you can't hold your significant other, your life partner, your husband, your wife, if you can't hold that person accountable for what they do and hold them responsible for what they do, and if they aren't able to receive that and understand that concept, then you're gonna have a problem with your business. And your business is not gonna be as successful as it could be, because one person isn't gonna be able to uphold their end of the bargain. They're not gonna be able to play the position well, which is gonna have fallout too for the employees. So keep that in mind, that's very, very important. Another thing too, as far as business owners or those family members, when you do have that family and you have those children, you have those other relatives, this is simple, but it's hard, and I know that it is, but it's something that we need to definitely work on doing, and that's being fair and consistent. Be fair and consistent, especially when it comes to your children. A lot of times in life, we tend to not be fair and not be consistent with our children, and it really, really hurts them, and it puts them at such a disadvantage to where they have self-esteem issues, they have problems with their other siblings, things like that. A lot of times as parents, we have parents that have children, and one child may be really similar to one parent or the other, and that particular parent takes a liking to that child more. And that's okay to do that as long as you're being fair and consistent. Because at the end of the day, if you have if you're a mother and you have a daughter, or you have a son and you just basically dote on one or the other a little bit more than that one because of how you guys get along, the dynamics of your relationship and things like that, that happens where that child may be your favorite or whatever the case may be. If that happens, you should still be able to be fair and consistent, and that child should be able to see that and demonstrate that when they get older. They should be able to say, yeah, you know, this my mom did like my brother better or my sister better, but she was always fair and consistent either way. So they can have that special bond and that special dynamic, but be fair and consistent with your children. Be fair and consistent with your other relatives at the end of the day. Don't do anything for one particular relative or one particular child that you wouldn't do for the other. And at the end of the day, be able to speak to that. So if you do say, well, I let this child do this and I didn't let this child do that, let there be a valid reason, not just any reason that you're just making up, but let it be a valid reason as to why that is. So make sure that you keep that in mind. Keep that at the forefront, fair and consistent. Another thing too, and I guess this is the biggest thing for me. This is the main point. This is like if it was possible, all of the lights would just be focused and you would get the close up and the music would kind of like stop and then you'd be like, go. And I would say then, love each other enough to offend them to good works. And at the end of the day, what I mean by that is have enough love in your heart for that person to offend them so that they can always do what's right and do whatever it takes for them to be better. If you are able to do that, then at the end of the day, even if they get mad at you, even if they don't like you no more or they can't stand you, whatever the case may be, if what it is that you're doing, if it offends them or upsets them, but it makes them better, then so be it. Because that is what's really important, is what a person becomes, and your impact on that person's life is what's important. It's not about being somebody's friend and saying what they want to hear. It's about saying what it is that I'm saying to you, what it is that I'm trying to give to you, what it is that I'm doing to you. The reason why this is happening and I'm choosing this path for you is because it's going to make you better. At the end of the day, that's what it's all about. It's all right to offend somebody to good works. They may not like you in the moment. They may not like you after you say what it is that you said, but at the end of the day, when you can say and you can look them in the face and say, you know what I said to you may hurt your feelings, but it was for your good. It was to offend you to a good work. Then that's what it's about. That's how you change people's lives. That's how we can change the world at the end of the day. So make sure that you remember that part if you don't remember nothing else. Also too, like, share, subscribe to this channel, please. All right, I need these likes. Click that little like button and go ahead and subscribe to what it is that we're doing to this channel. Pass this on to your friends. If you know me and I know you, then you better have subscribed. And if I don't know you, subscribe so we can get to know each other. That's how we start out being friends in this relationship, and that's what we can do. It's gonna be wonderful. But at the end of the day, I am Brian Redman. This is the Relationship Rehab. And as always, I love you and I'm out.